So I have 30 minutes. Wait. Okay. So I'm from University of Tokyo, not Tokyo, but Tsukuba. It's about 1 hour from Tokyo. And my name is Shingo Imai. Thank you for coming. And today I'd like to talk about this. Is CAT suitable for automated speaking test? The answer is yes and no. Okay. Maybe some part yes, some part no. Now I work with the team, with a big team like this, and there are some specialists for the CAT and IoT, and myself is Japanese language teacher, and I have the richest interest in the theoretical point of view, cognitive semantics, and corpus linguistics and Japanese syntax, and from a practical point of view, I'm interested in developing e-learning and the teaching material like textbooks or dictionaries, and also interested in automated scoring test, which I'm talking about today. And right now, I'm very much interested in to create language teacher, virtual language teacher, by using AI. And the project background, we developed JCAT and from the 2005, it's in operation. And from 2010, we moved to the SJCAT development, and now it's open to the public, and you can access here, access to the SJCAT on the web. The reason we developed the JCAT, just it's because it's too much work of placement tests. Every year, every semester, we accepted so many students from foreign countries, and they don't come in together. They come one by one after another. So every time they arrive to the university, we have to give the placement test. It's just too much. So we developed a test with computer. So now the computer can do that. So that's very, it was very helpful. And after the JCAT, there's some criticism. Because the JCAT, it has the vocabulary, grammar, and listening and reading, but it doesn't have speaking and writing. So when it comes to communication skill, you have to check the speaking and the writing proficiency, which was not possible. So we started working on the SJCAT, that's a speaking Japanese CAT. And other reasons actually, it's very hard to do the interview, speaking test. You have to train testers. It's not just a one-day training, but you have to go for weeks and weeks for training the testers. And even after training, maybe after 2 years, you have to retrain the trainers. Okay. So that's burden for us to train the trainers. And also the interviews, that's like 30 minutes of OPI, it lasts about 30 minutes. And you think about the 30 minutes for one person, and you have to take the interview for 10 people for one day. No, it's really hard. And the cost, you have to hire the testers, and the big issue is the disagreement between and within testers. Between testers, if you ask two testers and ask them the score, give the score to the examinees, yeah, usually they agree, but sometimes they disagree. And within testers means if you start from examinees and after 1 day or 2 days, if you do the same test, you may change your score. So there's this agreement between and within testers. So to avoid that, we wanted to develop a speaking test on computer. And JCAT, I just give some background of JCAT. JCAT is a web-based test to diagnose the proficiency level of Japanese as a second or foreign language. And it has four sections, listening, vocabulary, grammar, and reading. This is from the web page of IACAT. Okay, this is the starting page for the JCAT. For the JCAT, you can do it by yourself. It's set for individual, and you can do as a group. Group means if you have 100 students for university, you can ask the JCAT office, and the JCAT office provides the ID and the password. And after the test is over, we put all the records, the ID, names, and the result in the CSV file, and we send the CSV file to the institution. And this is SJCAT top page, it's almost the same as a JCAP. And before we started working on developing SJCAT, we went some survey and what's available right now, you know, the speaking test. And most of the speaking tests, even if it uses a computer, and, human raters are checking or scoring the after the recording the voices of the examinees. Like IELTS speaking or TOEFL IBT, TOEIC speaking test, Cambridge English, they're all available basically, but they are recorded and or recorded or interview. And after that, the human raters have to check and give a score. There are two automated scoring systems available. One is speech rater by ETS and the other is Bassam by Pearson. Okay. But speech rater by ETS is not a test, it's a practice because it's not validated, I think. It's not ready for the test, but so it is just a practice. And the Bassam is the only the automated scoring speaking test, as far as I know. There are some under development, but as far as I know, which is on the market, is just the one, this one. And it has a reading test, the repeating test, the short answer question, the sentence builds, and the story retelling, the open questions. But one thing I noticed, okay, when I checked their report, it says open question task is used to collect longer spontaneous speech samples. Candidates' responses to items in this section are not scored. Yeah, not scored, but available for review by authorized listeners. Okay. So even if the Bassam provides the open question, but they are not scored. So our SJCAT have two sections. One is the section one and section two. The section one includes sentence reading aloud. Read the sentence on the screen after listening to a module reading. And this is the example. Oh, the sound doesn't come out. I was told the sound is coming. It is connected, but it's not. The sound speaker.
できません。違うとに差しない、もしかして。 いいですよね。
最大ですか？ 最大。 Okay, it's all coming, so I just saying what it says, okay.
マイクで拾うとかね。
Sorry, okay, I just said, it said, sumimasen, kite kudasai. Maybe you don't understand Japanese, but it says that please go and get some stamps for me or something like that. So after that, there is a module sound. And after the listening to the module sound, you just repeat. So in this section, we check the pronunciation. And the next type is multiple choice reading. Look at the picture and read aloud one sentence among three sentences on the screen. Okay, this is another example. The sound doesn't come out, but it's coming.
Okay. Maybe it works now.
If I connect it, the sound's gone. Okay. Anyway, it says, now look at the picture and pick up the most appropriate sentence from the three sentences below and say, just read it. And the recording starts like this. And after the recording, this is the practice session, so you can see, you can hear your voice. If your voice is recorded properly or not. And after the, once the real test starts, there's no checking your voice. So before start the real test, you have to check your voice. And next, sentence generation. Look at the picture or watch the video clip and describe the scene for about 10 seconds. And the next one, the open answer. Open answer, you have 10 seconds to preparation after you hear the question. And about 30 seconds, you have to speak something. And the maximum 45 seconds for recording. So for instance, do you agree or disagree with something like a nuclear power generation and why? Or which do you prefer A and B, like a rural area or urban area, which do you like and why? So the question goes, okay. Answer the question. Which do you prefer, in a rural area and urban area, and why? In the 10 seconds, you have to prepare what you're going to talk about, and start recording, you start speaking. Up to 40 seconds, you can record your voice. And this is a sample of the answer. Maybe you don't understand, but this is focusing on the long vowel, and this is focus on the long vowel and the short vowel. Okay. And this is open answer.
なぜなら自分の国が困る時もあるんだと思いますからです。
Okay, here maybe you don't understand Japanese, but you can feel how fluent she's speaking. Okay. And this is a CAT system, so it, like an ordinary CAT system, we have a question pool and a selection of question, after that, automatic scrolling, after that, ability estimation, and the convergence judgment. If it comes to the below the threshold of error, it stops. Otherwise, you have to go to another question. For the pre-test sampling, we did like this. 90 items was created, and 192 examinees took the participated in this sampling. And for each sections, we had like 70 or 80 items. And to fill in the blanks, in the middle, the fill in the blanks, we made 10 items because we thought this is very good on test for the speaking because this is the most restricted question because there's a blank and you just fill in the blank with the appropriate word, not a sentence or a phrase, but a word. So that's the simplest one. So we thought this is easy for automated scoring, but it turns out very bad. So we dropped all the fill in the blanks questions. And also, we dropped some of the questions after the pre-testing because some of them are not good according to the A parameter. So we had less than 80 items in the pool. Speech and timing distance, these are all the features which the automated scoring system is using, like speech and timing distance. Native, we have the sampling standard for native speakers. And we compare the sound with the examinee's sound. We calculate the difference between the speech timing. Like Ohio means good morning in Japanese. Ohio is good pronunciation, I think. But if you say Ohio, it sounds different, sounds awkward. So we calculate that timing. And the timing becomes bigger, the score goes lower. Fundamental frequency distance, this is intonation. Again, Ohio is good, but Ohio sounds awkward. Then the difference is big and the score goes lower. Speaking rate, to check the speaking rate, we calculate the morpheme length. Morpheme is the one sound, one tiny sound. Like test, in Japanese we say testo. Te is one morpheme, su is another morpheme, to is another morpheme. We check the length of the morpheme. Also, we check the speech length. We also check the sound length. We also check the pausing length. And we also calculate it according to reading, recording length. Though the speech rate, by using all the features, calculate the speech rate, 1, 2, 3, 4 is missing, and the 5 comes like this. Why is four missing? Because we thought that 4 is good also, again, but it turns out very bad indicator, so we dropped the speech rate 4. So another one, vocabulary diversity. Word types over root two times word tokens. Okay. It means if you speak with variety of vocabulary, the score goes up, but if you repeat the same word again and again, the score goes down. Keyword checking. We developed a list of the keywords after the transcription of sample answers. So if you say, if the question says, talk about something about your hobby, talking about the nuclear power generation, okay? And then you talk about the hobby. I like swimming, I like jogging, something like that. So keywords are missing. So in that case, we just ignore the answer. You get 0 in that case. And the frame average of acoustic dichotomy. This is the checking of the pronunciation. Acoustically, it is okay or not. We check it. So first level correlation between human ratings and machine rating. So we ask the teachers to score first, and from 0 to 4. So 0, the lowest, 4 is the highest, and 1 to 3. And we did the same thing for the computer. And the correlation is not so bad. Now, surprisingly, open answer was so high. And the sentence reading, which we expected, that's an easy one for the automated scoring. So I thought the correlation between sentence reading, human rater, and computer was high, but actually it turned around. But if you check the RMSE, so sentence reading is better than open answer. And after that, to give the proficiency level to the examinees, we use one parameter graded response model, like this. So 0 is the lowest, and the 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 1, 2, 3, 4, we have this one. And instead of the dichotomous one, which comes with one line, it comes with 5 lines. And the correlation between JCAT and SJCAT. JCAT, as I told before, it has the grammar, vocabulary, listening, and the reading. So it checks the knowledge of the language, Japanese proficiency. Not proficiency, but the language, actually. Knowledge. So if you see the JCAT total and the SJCAT, 0.45, it's middle. Okay, not so high, not so low. But if you check the listening, SJCAT comes higher. So that's, I think it's okay because the speaking and the listening are correlated to some extent, so it's okay. But if you check the grammar in the SJCAT, no correlation at all. That's also what we expected, because even if you know grammar, very good, good knowledge of grammar, but you cannot speak, it happens. So there's no correlation between grammar and SJCAT, that's good. And after that, second level correlation between human raters and machine rating. So human raters, this is JSST, this is 3 human raters give the scores after recording. Okay, we compare this test and our test. And we asked 178 participants for this correlation experiment. And minimum is 4, so SJCAT starts from 0 point to 100 points. So minimum is 4, the max is 94. JSST, it starts from level 1 to level 10. So in our case, minimum is 1 and max was 9. And the correlation was like this, okay? 0.615, not so bad, but not so good. But we got this one, 0.812. That's really high. Okay. What's the difference between this one? Okay, two correlation. The first one, it comes with 178 participants. But it turns out that many of the participants were intermediate or advanced learners and not the beginners. But for the one university, which comes with 60 participants, it distributed it, the population was distributed nicely, starting from the beginners, intermediate, and advanced. That's why the correlation gets higher. And 0.8 is very nice, because if you, you know, ask two human raters, they hardly get 0.8. Not hardly, but sometimes yes, but not always. Okay. So I think that this is really a good indication that this computer must automated scoring is maybe reliable. The issues of JCAT, okay. Distribution of the item difficulty parameter, this is a very, very big problem for us, because now we cannot expect the difficulty level. First, we thought, you know, maybe introduction yourself, that's an easy one. And the talk about the nuclear plant, that's a difficult one. We thought so. So starting from the beginner, intermediate, advanced. But it turns out it was not the case, because even if self-introduction, advanced speakers can speak maybe two minutes or 5 minutes, not only talking about your name, but your proficiency, your professionals, your background, or whatever, your hobby, or whatever. Okay. But beginners, maybe just he or she can say the name and hello, something like that. So even if the topic is the same or question is the same, still, some people can speak a lot, some people cannot. So it's not like ordinary CAT. The ordinary CAT, you can say this item is difficult one, this item is easy one. But for the speaking, it doesn't turn out like that. So it's really difficult to control the B parameter. And the good items, bad items, we thought reading aloud is an easy one for the automated scoring, but it turns out the open question was good. So as long as you change the parameters for checking the scoring. We did the try and error, or error and try, many, many times. And we came up with a good combination for the calculation or algorithm. And the shorter time, test time, the convergence of theta is very short compared to the dichotomous one. This is faster than the dichotomous. Like JCAT, it takes about 45 to 90 minutes to finish, but for the speaking, about 10 minutes. So the equation is a big problem, because if you want to create a big pool, you have to do the equation, but as I mentioned before, the B parameter control is almost impossible for a speaking test. So what we suggest is the deep learning with reinforcement. What it means is that you just do it, all the tests at once, placement at once, forget about equating, just make it at once. That's our suggestion. So in that case, you have only small pool of equations, okay? Is that a problem or not? I think it's not a so big problem for a speaking test, because let's think about if you want to go to speech contents, okay? Speech content, you have to write a draft, you have to practice a lot of pronunciation, intonation, or whatever. So even if the topic is the same, but still you can distinguish poor speech and good speech, okay? It's almost the same thing with a speech test, I think. Even if the topics are so limited, still if you can speak fluently, it shows your fluency, it shows your proficiency. But even if the topic is the same, you cannot speak a lot, or you cannot speak fluently, it shows your lower fluency. So I don't think you need 1,000 topics for the speaking test. The only limited number of speaking test topics still, I think they work. Future task, operation on the web, because we are using web, so you need a high speed connection, because for the data, it's very big. Unlike the ordinary CAT, we have to do the voice recognition, Okay. Now, because of that, the data is big, so you have to have the high connection. And the speed of scrolling, it takes about 15 seconds or 20 seconds to check the open question. For the short sentence, it's OK, 5 seconds or 3 seconds. But like 30 seconds or 45 seconds, it takes about 15 or 20 seconds. You have to wait until you get the next question. And the operation cost, it's nothing for the human data, but we need a big server. And the security, I don't know about the security. Because of the security, you have to hide the pool. Okay? But as I mentioned before, maybe even if you steal the pool and steal all the items, I think it's still okay. Because this is low, very, very low stakes. And this is used for the placement test. So let's say that one bad guy goes into the system and steals some items in practice and a lot. I'm not sure if he can, if she or she can do the better, no, even if his or her process is very low, and after that, if he practice, I don't think he can do it. Okay. So the security is a different issue, but I don't think we have to worry about the security too much compared to the ordinary CAT system. And another issue, it's just placement test. Even if you do some cheating and you get the higher score, it's bad for you because you are placed to the advanced class and you get a failure after the semester. Okay. Okay, that's it. All right. I have 5 minutes or 6 minutes for questions and comments. Yes, please. No.
What do you think you're going to find?
I think it's almost the same thing because you cannot speak better after 5 minutes or 10 minutes, right? That's what you say, right? You should take the test again and again.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that almost the same thing happens. I mean, the same score comes out. Right.
I was brought in to help figure out how do you detect people who cheated low.
It happens. Yeah,
rate.
It happens. Even if for the human laters, it happens. Yeah, but we cannot do anything about that.
Yeah, actually, I do believe you could. Mm-hmm. In that we found using IRT, you could detect that something that's easier to do, people were actually doing worse. You know, they did it this level, but if
Now, actually, it happens for our university, and after placement, this is not a placement for our university. Our university using another test for the placement test, actually. And after that, some person came, actually, he or she said that, I want higher grade for this class because blah, 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 so can I stay here? And we say, no, go, another class. You are not too advanced. We just do that after the placement test. We don't believe in the 100% the placement test. After that, the teacher can ask students to move to another room. So it's okay, not so problem. No more? Okay, so this system is available. If anybody wants to buy it, please contact me. Okay. I'm going to finish this project because my interest is going to the AI. So if you really want to do some of the development for this speaking test, we are very welcome to ask somebody to put forward this project. Thank you very much.
Thank you.